Hello everyone. So in this video we are going to see conversion from fractional decimal to hexadecimal. So these are the important questions which are generally asked in Karnataka PGCET and other PGCETs for PG courses. So these are the 1 mark problems. So these are somewhat easy, but we need some practice to solve them. So I am explaining one problem here. So you can try the different combinations of this form. And if you want to know more, then you can visit our website. Okay, so the problem is a decimal number is given as. So they have given a decimal number, that is 22.64. Then find the value of hexadecimal equivalent number. So they are finding or trying to tell us to find the hexadecimal equivalent number of the 22.64. So the decimal value 22.64 has to convert it to the hexadecimal form. So it consists of two parts here. So the step one consists of solving the problem or part which is on the left of the decimal point, that is 22, and in second step we will be solving the part which is on the right of the right hand side of the decimal point, that is 0.64. So first step, first take decimal part. Okay, so the first decimal part is 22 here. So 22 I have taken, so why I am dividing it with the 16 is I am converting it to the hexadecimal. So hexadecimal means base value will be 16. So that I am dividing it with the help of 16. If you are converting it to the octal, then we need to divide it with the help of 8. If you are converting it to the binary, then divide with 2. Okay, so like this, depending on the to what value we want to convert, we need to decide the divisor here. So 16 I need to take as a divisor. So 22 is divided with the 16. So 16 ones are 16, and there will be left 22 minus 16 is equal to the 6. Okay, so in next step, again divide with 16. So 1 is less than 16, so it is no more divisible with the help by the 16. So I don't divide, and I will write 0 as it is, or 0 straightforwardly. So the hexadecimal equivalent of the 22 is 16, that is 16. So it will be MSB to LSB. So this is MSB and this is LSB here. So 16 in the 16. So I have solved the first part, that is I have converted 22 to the hexadecimal. So I need to convert the 0.64 to the hexadecimal as well, if I want to convert completely the 22.64. So in the second step, consider fractional part, that is 0.64, and here I have divided, here we need to multiply. So 0.64 into 16, so the answer will be 10.24. Take the decimal value, that is the value which is on the left hand side of the decimal digit or decimal point, then we will be left with here 0.24. So this is taken as a carry, and it is equal to 10. So the 10 can be written as A in the hexadecimal. So we know that in hexadecimal up to 9 we will be writing decimal and hexadecimal as it is, but when it comes to the decimal value or hexadecimal, then it will be from 10 onwards, it will be A, B, C, D, E and F up to the 14 or 15 values. Okay, so I have written here the A. Now take the second fractional value, that is we have got 0.24 just now, so multiply it again with the 16, so we will be getting 3.84. So the 3 is the decimal part, take it outside, and we will be left with only 0.84. So 3 in hexadecimal can be written as 3 itself, because up to 9 it will be same. So again 0.84 is taken and it is multiplied with 16, so we will be left with 13.44, 13 taken outside, and it is equivalent to D in hexadecimal, so we will be left with 0.44 here. So 0.44 is again multiplied with 16 and we will be left with 7.04. So 7 is taken as the decimal part and it is written as 7 in the hexadecimal. Okay, so the only part which is left is 0.04 here. So it will be continued up to whenever, until we get very low value. Okay, so I have got 0.04, so it is almost equal to the 0, so that's why I will stop at this moment. So the hexadecimal equivalent number is 16. So for 22 I have got 16, and for the right hand side of the decimal point, that is A3D7, so it is read for like this. So this is MSB to LSB. So because it is, since it is on the right hand side of the decimal point, it is, so these values are left from bottom to top, and these values are read from top to bottom because these are on the right hand side of the decimal digit. So A3D7, and this is the hexadecimal equivalent of 22.64. so let us take a quick recap what we have done. So we have split the problem into two parts, the right hand side and left hand side. So first we will take left hand side. Okay, so we will be dividing it with the help of 16, and we will be writing the MSB to LSB values, whatever we will be getting. So in the second step, we will be considering the right hand side of the decimal digit, and we will be multiplying here it with the help of 16, and we are taking the decimal part, and we are continuing the fractional part to the next step here. Okay, so we are also writing the hexadecimal equivalent of the decimal parts what we have got. Okay, so like this, we will be continuing these steps until we get a very low value. So once we get a very low value, then we will be writing the hexadecimal value which we have got previously and the present hexadecimal value which we have got. Okay, so the combinedly we will be getting the hexadecimal equivalent of the given fractional number. So like this, we can solve the problems easily, and they can fetch a good marks in the competitive exams. I hope you like the video, and if you are new to the channel, please guys hit the like button and subscribe the channel for more updates. Thank you. Thanks for watching.